I have a bunch of chicken bones here, and since birds originated from dinosaurs, maybe I can build a dinosaur skeleton. In this video, we're gonna look at the bones of a living dinosaur, the bird skeleton. It's gonna be exciting. Welcome to the Natural History of Dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Berger. I'm a paleontologist at Utah State University, teaching in the heart of Utah's dinosaur country in Vernal. All right, let's see what we have here in our box of bones. Well, first we can identify our beautiful skull here, and obviously not very dinosaur-like. This is a chicken skull, and the first thing we notice, of course, is there's no scary teeth. They have a beak. We also notice that the bones are very slender in this chicken. Notice that there's no anaorbital fenestra, or kind of like one that might be in here. You even see that the openings in the back of the skull, back here for the jaw muscles, are pretty small here. Most of the skull is taken up. I can grab the lower jaw. Most of the skull is actually taken up by this really big swollen brain here. And big, of course, orbits. So not very slender skull, not very dinosaur-like. Much bigger brains than we saw with dinosaurs, and very nimbly built. So let's put this down here. All right, so let's go on. We have some cervical vertebrae. Let's see, neck vertebrae here. Now the neck vertebrae look a little more dinosaur-like. They have these wonderful little pneumatic portions to them. So they're very lightly built. You can see there's a lot of openings for them and pretty complicated articulations between the neck vertebrae here. These openings here for the vertebral artery going through, but very slender sort of looking vertebrae. So these vertebrae are very much like what we'd see in dinosaurs. This is an interesting bone. You probably recognize this bone. This bone right here is the wishbone. Ah, but what bone is this on dinosaurs? Anybody want to take a crack at that? To make a wish? All right, so let's look at the limb bones here. See what we have. Let's see what we got here. We have the humerus. Here's the left and right humerus bones. So you can identify those. And then we have the radius and ulna. We have the two sets, radius and ulna, on either side, just like in dinosaurs. That's good. So we have left and right. But wait, what are these bones? These bones are something different. These are the wing bones, but they don't look like claws or hands like we saw with dinosaurs. There's something very different about these. These are interesting. Wonder what those are. All right, diving down, we got our lower limb. We have our two femurs here. Here's the left and right femur. So, got those. And we have the tibia and the fibula. The fibula is really kind of almost like fused onto this, to the tibia. So this is the knee part of the tibia, and this is the distal part here with this wonderful articulation. But that means that we got an extra part of the foot down here. We got this really long bone here. You can see it looks like it's kind of a fusion of some bones. That's a new bone there, and it's a bone that's very unique to birds. We'll talk about the origin of this extra bone in the foot. Obviously, here we have the foot, clawed, kind of dinosaur-esque looking. Oh my gosh, what the heck is this bone? This thing is bizarre. What do you think that is? I don't know. It kind of looks a little familiar, like this might be the bone that you encounter when you're cutting off the meat to make the breast meat. That is just a bizarre, weird bone. I wonder what that is. And then, oh my gosh, look at this bone. This is the weirdest bone I've ever seen. Look at this thing. It's like some space alien thing. This isn't something we haven't seen with dinosaurs. I mean, what the heck is this? Dinosaurs are supposed to have like normal, you know, three-part pelvis thing, and this is like a space alien thing. And look at this is the tail. And it's got this extra little weird bone at the end of the tail. All right, we got a couple extra bones in here, mention. We have the coracoid here. The coracoid is interesting. Here's a left and right coracoid. And what's really interesting about it is it's got this really interesting hook at the end right here. We'll talk about that. And we got a rib here. And I think the rest are all ribs that we have in here. A couple stray neck and thoracic vertebrae. Here's a nice neck vertebrae. And we also have in here a... these are the sclerosicles. These are the ones, little bones that you find in the eye. You find that in some reptiles and dinosaurs and birds have that. And then we got lots of miscellaneous ribs in here. So this is our skeleton to work with, and hopefully maybe we can build, you know, a skeleton like this and assemble it. But obviously the bird skeleton has some very different things than we see in dinosaurs. Just by looking at the bones of a modern chicken, there was a lot of evolutionary changes that must have occurred with the origin of birds. Let's take a look at the bird skeleton in detail now. The skull is slender and more lightly built, with more room for a larger brain and larger eyes. The first novel bone is the furcula, a spring-loaded bone that is present in the chest of modern birds. It helps keep the chest expanded. Now, everyone knows this bone as the wishbone. Now, this giant bone is the carinate sternum, or keeled sternum. It holds two important muscles for flight, the pectoralis major and the supracorticoideus muscle. The pectoralis muscle pulls the humerus downward during the down flap of the wings, while the supracorticoideus has the opposite action via a tendon that wraps around that hook in the coracoid bone that we saw. This sort of acts to raise the wing, and then the pectoralis lowers the wing. The supracorticoideus raises the wing and you get the flapping action. Dinosaurs have a small sternum and they lack any notch for the supracorticoideus muscle in their coracoid bone. Now this large sternum supports the large flight muscles, which are present in chickens and forms the breast meat. This extra bone in the wing or foreleg is the carpometacarpus bone, a bone formed from the wrist bones. The wing has these extra bones that likely formed from the finger and wrist bones. But how? They don't look like the claws of any dinosaur. We'll look at how the carpometacarpus formed later on. The extra bone in the foot is called the tarsal metatarsus, which has a triarticular surface of three articulations. Now, if you've ever seen a bone like this, you know that it's a bird bone. The tarsal metatarsus is a very distinct bone, common to birds. Now, the foot is actually composed of four toes. They can point forward with three toes in the front, which is called the anastactyl condition, or they can have two toes pointed forward and two pointing backward. This is called the zygdactyl condition and is found in parrots and songbirds and perching birds. This is very different than what we saw in dinosaurs. This big bone in the back is called the syncsacrum. It's a fusion of the sacral vertebrae and all the hip bones. Interestingly, the pubis is a tiny sliver of a bone that projects backward. This bird hip is very different than what you find in dinosaurs, as it is a fusion of many bones to form of the hip to form one single bone. The caudal or tail vertebrae end with a pygostyle. This is a flared little bone that supported the tail feathers. So birds don't have a long, stiff, bony tail. That's just one more thing to add to the list of new things to know about the bird skeleton. So birds are really different from dinosaurs. How did all these changes happen? How did you go from a small theropod dinosaur to a weird bird skeleton like this? We'll explore more of these differences. For now, you should be able to label these new, different bones found in the bird skeleton.